read that one more time for you?
Jeremiah 14 and 2. Judah mourneth in the gates thereof languish. They are black unto the ground. Uh-huh. And the cry of Jerusalem is gone up.
And the cry of Jerusalem is gone up. So when we said right there, the Hebrew word for black is kadar, meaning dark skin. So-called white man is not dark skin.
And these devils have the nerve to change the definition of kadar by saying that it means to mourn.
Right.
That's bullshit, man. Because that word is in reference to the Ishmaelite whose name was Kadar, man.
Welcome to Grand Bazaar Shops.
You got the Bible. You don't have the Bible dictionary. It tells you the real definition of what Kadar means, man. Like when you read in Solomon where it says, I'm black but comely as the tent of Kadar. That ain't talking about as the tent of mourning. It's talking about Kadar, which was he was an Ishmaelite who was dark skinned, and that was what his name was. It was Kadar,
dark skin,
which means dark skin. You got that right?
Kadar, right here. Kadar, in the Zadok's Compact Bible Dictionary, it says, Kadar, probably either mighty or dark. It said, one of the 12 sons of Ishmael, son of Abram, by Hajar or Hagar. It says, the tribe was descended from him and their territories. They were, for the most part, nomads, raising sheep, but sometimes intruding into villages. Their territory was in the northern part of Arabian Desert. Dark-skinned man. That's what that means. Them so-called gutter rats, man, they look just like the average white man out here. Huh? Just with the pointiest nose. Actually, right? To me, them fake-ass Jews, they have less pigment. They're the ones that really get fucked over by the sun, that really get eaten up and burnt up. And skin cancer and all of that stuff. That's the Most High paying him back for taking on that role. I gotta skip right quick, bro. Isaiah 29 and 22. Therefore,
that's a two-fold scripture.
And you're going to break off walk, or at least default over the
weekend. That's your proper understanding of that, because you bring it out about the wax pale. That word wax pale means to wax weaker. It means to become weak. That's what the word wax pale means.
Still fits for the simple. I'm going to read it anyway. Therefore saith the Lord power, Jehovah, who redeemed Abraham.
It means to become feeble. Right. That's what it means.
And then here it says, grow up the wax. Just concerning the house of Jacob, Jacob shall not now be ashamed, neither shall his face now wax pale. I mean, you know, that's a new speak on it.
Now, if you want to be technical, and we read it by the English, that's actually true to an extent, because the Jews are really the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Natives, man. We're not a pale race of people. We're shades of brown. We're different shades of brown.
In particular, the Southern Kingdom, which are the darkest, some of the darkest people of our nation. Yep. The Haitians, they're called the Haitians, the West Indians, and the Negroes.
Yep.
You get my word?
Yes.
Then I go into the description of the Lord.
Isaiah 29 and 22, right?
Yep.
That's from the Hebrew word. It's kawar. Hebrew word kawar. And it means to grow white, grow pale.
Esau ain't ever gonna let his technology try to help us too much, you know. So they call this BS out here with these cell phones, the internet, and whatever else. But we use it to the best of our ability, because even with the limited amount that he's allowing us to use, it falls back on him. His tongue falls back on him, his wickedness falls back on him, and he exposes himself.
But it's twofold. Yeah, meaning Israel's not going to wax pale, meaning we ain't going to turn into a nation of straight, melanous, Caucasian, you know, looking, pigmently challenged people. You know, and that's why that statement was made by the, what was his name? Basically, he was a prime general of Egypt. He was an Ishmaelite.
Yeah, and he went out black.
Came back red. Came back white.
He said white.
You know? That's true.
What segregation of Judaism are you guys?
Judaism is a religion.
Right.
That was all set up. We're Hebrew. We're the true Jews according to the Bible, the true Israelites. The people that you see on this sign, those are the real Israelites according to the scriptures.
Right.
And our message is to them. Salvation is coming to a chosen among these people. So we're out here to warn them and let them know that the second coming of who the world called Christ is on his way. Excuse me?
Yep. What about the brand?
trenches. What are you talking about?
Like the Koa Mimi tribe.
They're not the women, the tribe. Now some of our people are scattered, to be simple about, scattered amongst all the other nations. Yeah, but that's according to the spirit, they're gonna know
so
that they're
if they link back, they'll go back to like that time.
Right, but their spirits have to go back to this. But
so
their
what?
Spirit.
The true people of Israel, when the Lord returns, he's gonna bring all of them back together and they're gonna be in that in the land of Israel again.
So do you believe that Jesus has already come?
No.
Well, he hasn't made his second coming yet.
But he has come once.
He came and died.
Jesus
is
the Messiah?
Yes. Well, who the world called Jesus Christ.
All right. Okay. So that was the first Messiah. We're waiting for the second coming of the Messiah.
Yes.
Right. What book do you guys
read? The Bible.
The old
enemy testament.
The 1611 King James Version. 1611.
1611.
Yeah.
Translated from Hebrew.
Yeah.
Right.
Do you read Hebrew?
Yeah.
And speak Hebrew?
Yeah.
Do you read Hebrew prayer?
No.
That was Hebrew. Like what would be, do you do Shabbat on Fridays?
Well, not on Fridays. We do it when according to the explicit real understanding, which is according to the lunar calendar.
Even the lunar calendar, the first day of the week is Sunday.
No, there was no Sunday.
There was no such thing as Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
You know the Gregorian calendar that we follow, that Friday and Saturday and Sunday and all that was created on?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
We started on
the Lord.
We know before then, though.
Right.
You probably know the Assyrian Hebrew. Huh?
I don't know.
I mean, they're pronounced the same, but the characters are different.
So what alphabet?
The paleo.
Wait, and a Byzantine as
well.
Aramaic.
Aramaic, but now it's Aramaic. They're not, Hebrew and Aramaic are not quite the same.
Right.
But they're, you know.
Very similar. So what alphabet do you guys use?
We use the Paleo Hebrew.
So what is that alphabet? Like, what's the first letter? I'm curious. Interested, for real.
We're really only asking your questions because they're decent questions.
Do you guys have a name, though? Are you a religion, or you're just about the original tribe?
Just a set of people that want to believe in things. And so since for these people, according to nationality.
Okay.
According to their nationality. That's what it's looking for. You know? That's what the truth of it, because that's how your spirit travels, by who it's really for, through your father-in-law.
So, like, right now I'm Caucasian, but if I'm not all the way, like, he's not, because he's Central American. I know that, like, I know Columbus brought a bunch of, like, Jews during the Inquisition with him on his ship.
Yep.
So, like, if I could trace my lineage, what if it, I was part of these, but not 100%?
As long as your father-in-law goes back.
Father, so it's not standard Jewish law.
No,
they go by your mothers. They go by your father.
Right. Okay, so what's your alphabet?
This is your alphabet. This is the Paleo Hebrew, the Lashon HaKodesh. All right.
This is the Assyrian.
But this is the ancient Paleo.
Right.
This is the Hebrew that the Israelites were using.
Yeah. The more kind of thing.
Yeah. This is that what we're using. Okay.
So What word is one word for God in your
Hebrew?
Does that make sense?
Allah.
Allah?
The word for God, yeah, is Allah.
What about prayer?
Allah.
Huh?
Allah is Hebrew for praise.
Allah.
Like, but not Halil. Allah.
Because there was no, in the Paleo, there is no other vowel sound.
But Halil
and
is
God.
Technically like.
Right.
Right, because what happened is with Yiddish, there's a lot of people that think they speak Hebrew speak Yiddish. So which is a bastard form of Hebrew.
Right, because it's mixed with English and German
and German language with it.
That's when those Khazars came out of the Caucasus Mountains.
So were any of these tribes part of the Holocaust?
No.
No,
that's something.